Hey everyone, this is Nicole from Kenhub, and today I'm going to talk through a few simple steps that can help you pass your final exams in anatomy and physiology. So you have your final in anatomy and physiology looming around the corner, and you're wondering how you'll be able to study such a huge amount of information in time and remember everything. Well, not to worry, it can be done. One really great idea is to use online resources. In addition to your textbooks, online databases such as the Free Book Center or databases on many university websites might be useful to help you study, as you can plug what you're looking for straight into the search bar, saving you time and energy for the inevitably stressful exam period. And of course, using Kenhub to do your revision can significantly improve the effectiveness of your study sessions. Studies have shown that consistent and personalized revision, which you can do with Kenhub's personalized quizzes, can improve memory recall. So make use of these online resources that are available to you and avoid wasting valuable time flipping through pages and pages of material in textbooks. Next tip, make a schedule. I can't stress enough how important it is that you map out your plan of attack when it comes to revision and preparing for your exams. Making a schedule helps you visualize what you need to get done before your exam date, and it also helps you to plan and allocate time for each topic. Also, having a schedule written down allows you to refer to it at the beginning and at the end of each study day so that you can track your progress and see how much you've done and how much you still have left to do before your exam. In addition to making a schedule, printing out course materials from lectures, practicals, and assignments can also be very helpful for direct revision and making notes. The type of study environment you create is just as important as the resources that you use to study. You can have all the best resources available to you, but if you don't have a conducive study environment, you'll struggle to concentrate and retain the information that you're studying. So figure out what kind of study space works for you and stick with it. Before you sit down to study, prepare your study space so that you have everything that you'll need for your study session on hand. This is important because you want to avoid interrupting your studying to do something completely unrelated and thereby wasting valuable time. It's also worthwhile getting together with your classmates to ask questions, as this can help you consolidate your knowledge. But be wary of distractions or being told misinformation. Finally, learn the best way that you can. Spaced repetition, which is a learning technique aligned with the biological mechanisms of memory consolidation and learning that can be carried out using Kenhub's quizzes, has been shown to yield better results as opposed to panic-driven cramming sessions. Therefore, you should give yourself ample time to study at a good steady pace. Also keep in mind that when studying anatomy and physiology, many of the topics will overlap. So for example, if you're studying a topic in anatomy and you can connect it to a topic in physiology, this allows you to not only think about memorizing a structure, but also thinking about what it does or how it works. And this can be very effective in helping consolidate the learning process. The great thing about studying anatomy and physiology is that your body is your own reference manual. You have a musculoskeletal system, a cardiorespiratory cycle, a gastrointestinal tract, and so on. Thinking about the body's processes and imagining what's going on inside of you will not only make study more interesting, but it can help you more easily remember your anatomy and physiology topics. So apply all of these tips, don't forget to have fun, and good luck with your exam!
This tutorial might be over, but there are more videos you can watch related to this topic. You can also subscribe to our YouTube channel or go to our website where you'll find fun quizzes, related articles, and atlas sections. All you need to kick some gluteus maximus in anatomy and histology. I'll see you soon!